Hello everybody, and welcome back to the channel. We're sure glad to see you today. John Fix and I are on a roll. We found another mystery wrench that probably no one has ever seen before. Lucky find. We're going to show you today and give you a great restoration on this item. Let's get down to the shop and get started.
Well, I drove about 60 miles to an estate sale today from all the pictures and the ads. It looked like a great, great spot for tools. But when I got there, it was a lot of junk. Really cheap old tools that it had. Most of it they had painted over to make them look nice, I guess, for the pictures, with the old rusty patina tools with a coat of paint on them. It was a mess. But I did find this one old wrench, something really unusual looking. Well, it weighs a ton. That is one heavy dude. And good size. That's about, 14 inches, 15 inches. And looks in pretty good shape. Of course, it's patina and dirty. And I couldn't find any name on it. And I'm surprised that a wrench like this didn't have a name, but it's possible there's something underneath all of this crud. There is a ton of crud on here. It's been used. This back is mushroomed around where they hammered with it. And mechanism, working fairly good. They put some oil on it here to get it loose. And it is, I can get it unscrewed all the way. But I don't know a brand or anything. Unusual little handle design on it here, steel handle with a little ball on the end to give it a little style. Certainly looks pretty old. I'm thinking better than 100 years. So I'll try to find something, a picture of it online, to see if I can come up with a brand on it. And I guess I'll do some cleaning on it here to find out if I can determine a brand here. So I'll do a cleanup on this old dude. Well, after a very, very long session outside with the angle grinder and the heavy-duty twisted wire brush, got a couple results. First one is my finger, and that was through the heavy work glove. Whew. That's banged up bad. I'm getting ready to go repair that. But in the meantime, I'll show you where we are. There was a lot of crud on here, and basically the tool is two pieces. There's the upper piece with the adjustment screw, upper jaw, and the lower jaw assembled onto the handle, and this looks like it's permanently on here. There may be a way to get that off, but I don't think I'm going to tear that down. It looks pretty permanent on there. I did uncover something on here, and the name Laboga, L-A-B-O-G-A, or B-O-C-A, or B-O-O-A, L-A-B-O, and I don't know, it looks like a G, L-A-B-O-G-A, it looks like it was hand-stamped on there. It's probably a person's name. Don't think that's a factory mark. I can't find any other marks on here except on the bottom here. If I can find it. The letter B. Again, must be some kind of identifying mark. I don't know what else, but looks like I got most of the crud off, but I don't think it's still all off of there. It needs a good scrubbing, but I'll clean it real well next, then I'll put it on the bench grinder on my inside the shop here and see if I can't get it a little cleaner. Don't know exactly what I'm going to do with this wrench. Very interesting wrench, very heavy, heavy-duty wrench, so I'll go do a little repair on my finger, restoration on my finger, and then I'll come back and work on this. Well, it's a mystery tool. It's sure taken some work. about an hour outside with the angle grinder with a twisted heavy-duty wire brush on it, where I sustained my injury. That finger still hurts. And then another hour or more inside with my bench grinder with a medium and then a fine wire wheel brush. Got it pretty cleaned up. You can get a look at it after a lot of wire brushing. You know, a lot of pitting on it, but not too bad a shape. It's got a big crack. It's broken in the back here. And you can see where it's separated compared to the other side here. But it looks like that could be filled with JB Weld. Looks like old JB Weld type of repair. It's out of alignment a little bit. It needs to be banged back down and then filled with epoxy or JB Weld. But it looks like a JB Weld type of repair. The other section of it, well, I've uncovered a few things on this side. It's got, and it looks like it was hand stamped on here, L-A-B-O-C-A, La Boca. So, anyway, that must be a name. I don't know. Something French sounding, anyway. On this side, it's got the letters, well, C down here, C-M-C-N-P. Looks like initials, C period, N period, P period. And up here is a tiny little logo. Don't know if you can see that. Really, it's just like 3/8 high and 1/2 inch wide oval. And I looked at the name at the top, and I've translated it from French, and it says, at the gate. And then Paris, written real clearly across the middle here. And on the bottom, I can't make it out. I can't figure the letters out on the bottom. So, at the gate in Paris must have something to do, like, made in Paris. Why would it be at the gate? And then the word Paris. So, I'm assuming this was made in France. Got a model number 35 at the top, or 33. Yeah, 35, and then the letter E at the bottom. That looks like it was a factory stamp, not you know, not the letters on here like the other lettering. 35, and then E, and then that little oval with the at the gate Paris, and something at the bottom I can't figure out. I've blown it up as much as I can and tried to clean up the photo, but I can't get any more out of it. So, cannot get a brand on it. Got to decide what to do with the wrench from here. I think I'll, you know, if it was really an old wrench of some type that was really important, I wouldn't do anything from here. I just would have cleaned it up. But, heck fire, it's not no brand name on it, nothing I can find. I love the little ball on the bottom here on the handle. Interesting part. And again, it's just three parts. It's the upper jaw, the lower jaw on a little section here. And then actually, I guess the two parts are together. It'd be two pieces total, but the handle, and then it comes through, and then a turning knob here. Basically, simple operation, super heavy duty wrench. I sure wish I could find out a brand. Maybe somebody can identify it from my video here and tell me what this is. But it looks like it was made in France with the name Paris on there. So I'll see if I can't get this cleaned up and get it repaired and get a good looking wrench out of it. Here are the markings I found on the tool. I tried to interpret it as best I could. The only thing that stood out real clear was the name Paris, which I have named it the Paris tool. If anyone has seen anything similar on a tool, please let me know what you know about it. Okay, did a lot of research and talked to a lot of people and still can't identify this tool, so I'm going to call it the Paris tool. And I've been working on it. This is my fourth day now. It's unbelievable how much this has taken. I don't know what kind of coating was on here or paint was on here. It was black. I mean, it was just so hard. It took tons of sanding and scraping and sanding and back and forth till I finally got it cleaned up. But I want to get the tool prepped right. One thing I have done is, I don't know if you remember, but there was a big crack here where this side piece had separated, a big crack down here. And I wanted to fill it with a JB Weld, and I was looking for my black steel stick. It's a dark color. I guess I had used it all up and forgotten, so I had some what I call water weld, which is, again, just the same thing, but it's made to be water resistant. You can weld it and use it in areas that will be in a lot of moisture, and it'll hold. So I used it, and I left it. There's a lot of extra on here, but I found out when you just fill the crack with any adhesive, as it cures, it loses, it turns hard and it loses moisture. If it's water-based, it's water, and if it's not water-based and it loses the solvent or whatever's in there that keeps it pliable. So anyway, I did want to use the regular type epoxy. I wanted to use a mixable type that you mix that's hard and putty-like, I might say, a little stiffer than that. So I left it proud because I didn't want it to shrink and then show that line, so I'll have to sand that all down and get it smoothed out, but I think it'll do a nice repair. As far as the sanding and preparing this, there are a lot of nicks and scrapes and pits and things on here that just won't come out, but I think I've got a good preparation on it anyway. Just got some flaws that aren't gonna come out of here, but overall, it's still gonna be a good looking piece. Look at that big one on the end there. I don't know what caused that, but it goes deep, so can't take that out either. So I'm gonna go ahead and just finish my prep, get that sanded, and put a final finish on it. This is looking pretty good. Took, like I said, days and days to get it to this point. And again, I don't know if anybody knows on old tools, is there some special type of, must have been a coating. It wasn't like a paint. Stripper wouldn't remove it. Just hard, hard days on labor of sanding. Got it finally cleaned off, and it was just really baked on there, whatever it was. But I got it prepped now, so I'll get it finished up and go to the final finish. Well, my mystery Paris wrench has been quite a journey. I will say that I spent more time restoring this wrench than any wrench I've ever done in the past. And I've done some that took a lot of work. This one was just a chore from start to finish. Ran into days. I could only work so long on it and had to take a break. Just hours and hours of hand sanding all these little parts. And to get through this coating like I talked about on here, it wouldn't give. Paint stripper, acetone, tried every bit of little chemicals I could find and different methods and wire brushing. So finally just a matter of just sanding every little facet on here and every little corner and seam. But I got it done, and I'm very happy that I did, because I literally fell in love with this wrench. I don't know why. Maybe it was something about it. It was different. I just literally thoroughly enjoyed it, and in spite of the work, it was fun. So now I'm going to show you what I did, and I think I nailed it pretty well. Here it is restored, and it's just beautiful as far as, I can see. It's, I did all the right things. The super blue color was the right thing because it was a dark wrench. Never was a bright wrench or anything. there are some ripples and bumps and parts on here that wouldn't, you know, like I mentioned, it's not perfect, but it's a heck of a long way from where I started. You can see the finish on it all the way around. Just turned out beautiful. The repair on the back, it's a little darker because I couldn't get a shiny finish over that JB Weld, but it filled in perfectly. It's flat, smooth, and so it is repaired. I showed you the Paris name, and that's why I call it the Paris wrench. It's the only real identification I can put on it, and it is really unusual. That unusual handle design, just never seen another one like it. It's steel handle with that ball on the end, and we're just putting there for decoration, for looks. Works well now. I won't open it all the way. It takes a while to unscrew it all, but it opens quite wide. And I can't think of another way. I had the wrench shiny for a while when I was doing my prep work on it, and it didn't look like the right finish for this wrench. Black, dark, super blue finish is the way to go as far as I'm concerned. And again, I did it by, you saw the wrench, I shined it down completely. Just sanded it and sanded it and then buffed it and smoothed it and shined it before I did the super blue. And that's what gives it that nice reflective black look. Very pleased with this wrench. I guess I have to make it my favorite now. I said I fell in love with it. I seem to fall in love with a lot of tools. But this one just came out better than I expected. It was harder work than I thought, but I'm glad I did it. I had fun with it. You know, I've got a bare spot on my board, and I don't know why. When I did my last redo of my wall, I left a space. And I thought, someday I'll find, and I haven't put a tool there. It's been months. It says, someday I'm going to find the right item, and this wrench fits there perfectly. So it's definitely going to go on the wall. Thank you for watching my video. I hope you enjoyed it.